Hey guys, Clint here with Classic Firearms, wanting to highlight something pretty cool we got in here. And yes, we are at Take Aim Training and Range, and it's not a real sunny day, which is okay, because it was hot last week. But guys, let's talk about something that is hot, and that is Mitchell's Mauser's PPSH 4122. Yes, 22 calibered PPSH. Let's send it a couple rounds downrange real quick, why not? That is sweet. Now, when I think PPSH, though, I think drum mag. That's more like it. 50-round drum mag. Let's give this guy a couple of shots here. See how that works. There we go. What a cool little gun, guys. Again, what is it? Mitchell's Mauser's, or Mitchell Manufacturing Corporation, brings you the Made in Italy PPSH 41 chambered in 22. And it does come with that 110-round mag, but they also offer these 50-round drums, which I think are just pretty freaking neat, guys. What a cool gun. So yeah, if you're looking for something that is just kind of, you know, it pays homage to that classic PPSH that everybody knows with that very high rate of fire. Oh man, this thing is pretty fun. And who doesn't love a little 22 carbine, you know what I mean? Especially when it has a 50-round drum. All right, let's take this guy back. Let's go talk about it a little bit more. All right, guys, so if you've been around the channel for any length of time, then you know we're a fan of our Papasha style firearms. That includes the PPS 43, which we've had chambered in 7.62x25, which is a sweet round, and also 9mm, which is super cool because that's a really fun platform to shoot. And this PPSH 4122 by Mitchell's Mauser is no exception, guys. How cool is this thing? Now, my initial thought when looking at it is it kind of reminds me a little bit more of like a PPD 40 because of that, you know, extended handguard, or, you know, the wood forend going past where the magazine is, because anytime you think of PPS, usually you think of holding the firearm by the magazine. It's a little bit further out and you kind of grab it right here, barrels, you know, not really covered or anything, so just don't burn yourself, right? But this guy here is based off of the PPSH 41, which was, again, originally chambered in 7.62x25, was produced from 1941, hence the name PPSH 41, to 1947. And within that time frame, there were approximately 6 million of those submachine guns made in Russia, or the USSR, or whatever you want to call it, you know. Anyway, they were designed for, you know, tank crew members, infantry units. I mean, it was actually a very popular firearm within the infantry, and it was kind of like the iconic submachine gun on the Eastern Front there. So pretty sweet. I actually remember seeing this one, you know, image. It's like, you know, in Mother Russia, who needs a stool when you have a PPS? And the guy was literally sitting on the drum mag on the gun, and I just thought, okay, well, all right, if it works, it ain't stupid, I guess. So anyway, but a really cool gun that has seen service all throughout history and all throughout the world. I mean, even the Viet Cong were using it as late up to 1970 in the Vietnam War. So it's pretty crazy, right? Well, anyway, Mitchell's Mauser's pretty much today his historically correct reproduction or clone of the PPSH 41, but it's chambered in 22. And that's what you see right here. This is a carbine or a rifle, which is very nice. And it being chambered in 22 with this length of a barrel and this weight, full stock, there's absolutely no recoil whatsoever. This thing is just a heck of a lot of fun. And I think they did a pretty good job replicating too, this gun, you know. And also too, it being a 22 long rifle with a 16-inch barrel, guys, it's actually pretty quiet to shoot. I don't know if, well, I'm sure many of you who watch have shot 22 long rifle out of a rifle and found it to be not very loud at all. I'm not saying it's hearing safe by any means, but it's a fun plinker for sure. Always use your eye and ear protection, all right? But quiet little guy to shoot, 22 long rifle, which is, I think it's still pretty plentiful. I mean, we've got, you know, quite a bit of it. So if you guys are looking for some, check us out. Aguila makes some great stuff, by the way. And if you ever want to see Aguila talk about their products or anything, check out some of our NRA our NRA footage that we shot last year, back when we were allowed to, you know, go out and see people and, you know, not social distance. Anyway, this guy here, I think, again, they did a pretty good job at replicating the PPSH-41. You've got the shrouded barrel with the ventilation for cooling. And as I mentioned before, it being a 22, I don't think you have to really worry about it overheating, but you never know how many of these drums you might be running through it, right? And the original gun, of course, was designed to fire from an open bolt, select fire, direct blowback, and that's pretty much the operating system is the same, except it's firing from a closed bolt and is semi-auto, and it has this nifty little 10 round stick mag, a banana mag, I guess you could say, since it's not, you know, completely straight. It's got a little bit of a curve to it here. Anyway, it's a pretty interesting design on the magazine, so that way I guess you don't have just all this empty space right here in the magazine well, so whenever you pop this guy in here, it clicks in and it takes up a little bit of that. I actually like that quite a bit. Again, it's, you know, not the most common magazine to find, I don't think. However, it looks good. I think they did a pretty good job on that. Now, again, it's only a 10 round capacity though. And so if you want to do spice things up a little bit or give it that more original look, we've got the 50 round drums for it as well, which are a heck of a lot of fun. And on here, it's called the PPS 50. So pretty sweet 22 caliber mag that pops right into place there. And now you're ready to rock and roll, right? And so that's the look of it with the drum mag. Super cool little gun, guys. All right, as far as the controls go on this guy here, you'll notice your mag release is just forward of the trigger. It's actually in the trigger guard, and you just actuate it like I did. Just kind of push like that, pull, and you're ready to go. You can do like this, but these mags aren't designed to drop freely, so might not be the most comfortable thing. Just do that, pull, you're good. The safety on this guy is on the right-hand side of the firearm here. Vary to actuate for a right-handed shooter, just like this right here. There you go. Red is dead. You're ready to fire. White is safe, all right? Easy enough. Cool. Charging handle on the right-hand side. Again, it's just a really fun plinker, guys. 22 is just such a fun round to shoot, and I'm pretty sure a lot of us grew up with a 22 rifle at some point in our life. 22 revolver, pistol, semi-auto pistol too, man. That's, memories of just how much fun these things are. All right, very cool, guys. And again, I think Mitchell's Mauser also did a great job at the stock on this thing. It's a really good looking stock. Love the wood on it. Sling mounts too, right at the bottom of it. So if you wanted to throw a sling on this guy, have at it. Just all day, I think this would be a fun little plinker all day. All right, very cool. What more can I say other than if you want yourself an affordable PPSH to shoot, take a look at this one here, because it's chambered in 22. I mean, how much more affordable can you get, right? Ah, man, so much fun. All right, again, check out our Aguila ammo that we've got, great 22 ammo. That's typically what I take out here to the range to shoot if we're shooting on a 22 platform, like this guy right here. And again, we've got the 50 round drums, because 10 rounds are cool and everything, but if you can go 50, you know, let's just go 50, right? All right, like a lot of our giveaways. Anyway, speaking of giveaways, let's roll into not a 50 cal yet. I think we got a few in the warehouse that I want to. Anyway, getting distracted. Our current giveaway is the Honey Badger, guys. This feisty little beast is by Q, the official Q on Instagram. You can find them. And it's coming with the Vortex Spark AR red dot and also the Franklin Armory binary trigger. If you're not familiar with what a binary trigger is, we have a video out there that kind of breaks down the Fostech Echo line of triggers and also Franklin Armory's different binary triggers for different platforms as well. And you'll be able to find that video at the end of this video. It'll be popping up, you know, one of those little boxes and whatnot. So check that out. It does come with one 20 round steel mag, but I figured, hey, let's see if these classic firearms branded made in the USA mags by a very awesome brand, let's see if these feed all right. And yeah, they feed very well with 300 blackout. And for a lot of you guys may already know this, but 300 blackout and 5.56 are very similar cartridges. Not really the same as far as ballistics go, but cartridges, yes. So just be careful about there. Don't get your mags mixed up, because that would not be a good day, all right? Anyway, the Honey Badger by Q is a 300 blackout chambered sweet little pistol. Yes, it is a pistol. It does have the collapsible brace on it. And guys, it is a heck of a good time. And I mentioned too in the announcement is our giveaway on this guy that Q just has some pretty funny names that they come up with stuff. So Cherry Bomb for the muzzle device on here, sure. But they've also got the Thunder Chicken and Trash Panda suppressors, which will made up pretty well on this guy. So if you'd like to have a Trash Panda and your Honey Badger get together and make one cool product, definitely check out Q. I don't think you guys will be disappointed, all right? So again, this is our current giveaway, and you can get those entries in at classicfirearms.com. We'll have a banner right at the top of the homepage where you can click there and enter now to win this or whatever else it might say at that top page, all right? So check this guy out. I don't think you guys will be disappointed. And yeah, check out the PPSH 4122 here by Mitchell's Mausers. It's a heck of a lot of fun, guys. I've really enjoyed shooting this, and I think I'll continue to enjoy shooting it, all right? We'll leave it off there, guys. Of course, I would like to see your thoughts down in the comments below. Let me know what you think about this little guy, because I think it's pretty sweet, all right? And if you haven't already, go ahead and like that video for us. We work hard to try to bring you the best content that Classic Firearms can bring you guys, so keep at it, right? We'll try to keep at it. We'll keep doing it, all right? God bless you all, and we'll see you next time at classicfirearms.com.